start off this morning talking about our development objectives. So the previous generation Elantra was a very strong product. We were very successful with that product. So where did we want to take Elantra? So there were three key objectives. So the first was design. We wanted to continue to evolve the design. The second was to increase efficiency and also improve vehicle dynamics. Many of you know that vehicle dynamics has been a big emphasis for Hyundai in recent years. Hopefully you've experienced that in the Genesis, in the Sonata, in terms of ride, handling, steering, NVH. So we wanted to also take Elantra up to that new Hyundai standard. And of course increase the fuel economy as well. And then finally, we wanted to introduce new technology into the vehicle, both in terms of multimedia and other features, and in terms of safety. So let's start off talking about design, first on the exterior. So here you can see the new Elantra. We'll continue with a very sleek design. You can see our signature hexagonal grille in the front. You can also see the available LED daytime running lights below the headlights. As we go around the vehicle in the profile, you can really see the coupe-like design that we introduced with the last generation. We continue to have that with this model. This is limited. You can see the 17-inch alloy wheels that come on that model. We have turn signal indicators and then approach lighting as well. And then looking at the rear, I think during the drive today, you'll really get a chance to see the vehicle, how it looks on the road. I think it really has a good presence as you're following other vehicles around. You can also see here the LED tail lights. When you have proximity key, we also have our hands-free smart trunk, which will open the trunk as you just stand behind it with no other action. You can also see here in the deck lid, it's very aerodynamic. It really almost looks like it has a spoiler on it because it essentially has a spoiler built into it. So we'll talk about that more and other some of the other aerodynamic features in a little while. So now looking at dimensions, we already thought that Elantra was in the sweet spot in terms of dimensions. So similar size to the outdoor model, but we wanted to continue to push the proportion. So it's about an inch wider and then about 0.8 inches longer than the last generation. We talk about a lot about design, styling, fluidic sculpture, but of course proportion is very key to the overall vehicle design. So that extra, the little bit of extra width and length we have really helps give the vehicle a great proportion. And then in terms of the interior room, Hyundai is good at interior packaging, having a very efficient vehicle, small on the outside, bigger on the inside. And 2017, Elantra is large enough in the inside that it's actually classified by the EPA as a midsize vehicle. In fact, it's actually about the same size inside as a premium vehicle like Cadillac CTS, and even bigger than vehicles like the 3 Series and the 4. So they've talked about, in the segment, they're really high expectations. You can really get a lot in a compact car. And one of those things is the interior that's equal to some premium cars. So now, turning to the interior design, you see up here a little bit of the imagery, some of the inspiration of our designers. This concept of simple, modern, driver oriented was what the designers had in mind when they were designing the interior. Now, one of the keys to the interior design is the horizontal layout of the instrument panel. So this gives the vehicle really wide, spacious feeling inside, and it also gives a really prominent position for our new multimedia head units. So we have a new head unit called Display Audio, which Mike Evanoff will talk about, as well as our new navigation system. So really good visibility for those systems inside. And then some of the features on the vehicle, of course, leather seats, heated front seats. We also have heated rear seats. We have a color TFT in between the gauges in the cluster. 60-40 split folding rear seat, dual automatic temperature control. There's lots of features in the Elantra. So now let's kind of talk about the second objective, which is improving efficiency and vehicle dynamics. So one of the keys to doing that is to increase body rigidity. So in order to be able to have the best possible handling, you want to have a very rigid body. So we've spent a lot of effort on strengthening the body. And then the other thing that we did in terms of riding handling was did a lot of improvements to the suspension, especially the rear suspension. And then finally, we wanted to improve crashworthiness. And so the structural changes that we're making to strengthen the body overall, to give it more rigidity for better vehicle dynamics. We also did a lot of structural enhancements to improve safety as well. So talking about the body first, one of the things that we talk about often is the ever-increasing amount of high-strength steel that we use in our vehicles. And that's true for the all-new Elantra as well. In fact, we've gone from 21% high-strength steel, which was high in the last model, all the way up to 53% use of the high-strength steel in the new Elantra. We've also improved the torsional rigidity and bending rigidity as well. And then going through some of the structural changes, if you look on the upper left, this shows some of the structural changes in the front engine area, using a hexagonal section on the side rails, using hot stamping. In the middle, you see that the path, the load path going through the A-pillar is much straighter than it was before. The strengthening on the right around the cowl, firewall, A-pillar area. But in these presentations, we give out a lot of numbers, but this slide has my favorite numbers of all on it, which is about our use of structural adhesives. So in the previous generation Elantra, we did use some structural adhesives about 10 feet. But in the newer Elantra, we've increased that up to 394 feet of structural adhesives, so 40 times more than the previous model. And that makes a huge difference in giving this strength and feeling of solidity to the body. One of the things that we like to talk about is the aircraft industry. So I think there's still feeling that in the world of the automotive construction, that adhesives are new. We still tend to think about vehicle bodies as being all welded together. Of course, in the aircraft industry, adhesives are now well established as required for modern aircraft technology. And of course, this is an industry where safety is of paramount importance. So structural adhesives are really proven out at the highest level. And hopefully you'll feel that as you drive today. You'll feel that sense of solidity that we're getting from our adhesives. And as Jim mentioned, we have Dow here if you have any more questions about that. One of the displays we had outside, I hope you got a chance to see, was of the rear suspension in the Elantra. So in the previous generation, the rear damper was laid down quite a bit, and it was also pretty short. And in the all-new Elantra, the damper has been increased up to be almost completely vertical, and it's much longer than it was before. So it gives us much more suspension flexibility in terms of tuning the suspension, less stiction. So overall, the rear suspension is a big enhancement and enhances the overall dynamic character of the vehicle. So some of the changes that we made in terms of NVH, that was an area where we made changes in the front suspension. So the front subframe was previously rigidly mounted to the body, but now it's mounted with cushions to improve NVH. We've also decreased the size of the holes that are in the firewall. So you get a lot of sound coming through the openings in the firewall. We decrease the size of those holes in order to prevent intrusion into the cabin. We've also improved the carpet quality, the character of that, and also added felt into the wheel liners as well. You can also see here that in terms of wind noise, we're very very low in terms of wind noise. One thing that's not on here is the door glass. We actually increased the thickness of the door glass in order to reduce the wind noise. So the combination of the aerodynamic body, increasing the thickness of the door glass, gives us a really low wind noise as well. So now turning to powertrain, we're launching the all-new Elantra with two new powertrains. So the standard powertrain will be a 2-liter Atkinson 4-cylinder. It's made up with the 6-speed automatic. It's 147 horsepower, 132 pound-feet of torque, and it's rated at 29 city, 30 highway, and 33 MPG combined. The second engine, which we'll offer in a few months from now, is in our Eco model, and that's from our Kappa engine family. It's a 1.4-liter turbo GDI, 128 horsepower, but thanks to the turbocharger, 156 pound-feet of torque, down at only 1,400 RPM. That engine has not been fully certified yet, but based on our internal estimates, we're expecting it to be at 35 miles per gallon. So talking about the transmissions a little bit, as I mentioned, the base 2-liter engine will come with a 6-speed automatic transmission, but it's been enhanced for this generation. So there's a smaller oil pump for more efficiency, double ball bearing mechanism, a new valve body as well, and a new multi-disc torque converter. And then our Eco model with the Kappa 1.4-liter engine is going to be paired with our 7-speed dual clutch transmission. So this is a transmission that has been tuned for efficiency. You can have very sport-oriented DCTs, but you can also have eco-focused. And in the case of this vehicle, we've tuned the Kappa engine for the best fuel efficiency and applied our eco tuning to the DCT. Automatic or DCT equipped vehicles also have active driving modes. So there's an eco mode and a normal mode and a sport mode. The different modes change the torque map and the shift map for the vehicle. And in the case of going from normal to sport, the steering calibration is also changed as well. So I encourage you to try out the different modes today as you're in the different driving areas on the drive route. One of the things that, of course, you need to have a very efficient vehicle is not just efficient powertrains, but you need to have an efficient body as well. So the new Elantra has only 0.27 coefficient of drag, down from 0.28 on the last model. One of the things that helps this, besides the overall shape of the vehicle, are these wheel air curtains that we have. So if you look out on the vehicles in the area where there's the daytime running light, and there's also a display of this out in the lobby as well, there's an opening on the side of the VRL that actually allows air to come in to the wheel well and go around the wheel. And that essentially makes a curtain of air around the front wheels and reduces turning. We also have almost a complete undercover underneath the body. And then we also have a little square underneath the rear bumper as well. So all those, as well as the basic body shape, all combined for really low coefficient of drag that really